हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ सस्ती एजुकेशन इन भद्रजून। ये मैं आज आप लोगों के लिए क्लास 7th का सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स का चैप्टर 7 का 2.3 एक्सरसाइज बनवा था क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 लेके आया हूं। ये 2.3 का वीडियो टू है। आई हैव सॉल्वड अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो एंड आई हैव गिवन यू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 एंड योर होमवर्क। ओके, आई हैव यू हैव केयरफुली डन दैट। ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 इज लिपिका रीड्स ए बुक फॉर वन होल थ्री बाई फोर आवर्स एवरी डे। She reads the entire book in six days. Okay, next one is what? How many hours in all were required to her by her? A car runs 16 kilometers using 16 kilometers. A car runs 16 kilometers using 1 liter of petrol. How much distance will it cover using 2 whole 3 by 4 liters of petrol. Lipika reads a book for one whole 3 or 4 hours every day. She reads the entire book in 6 days. Okay. If Lipika is taking one whole 3 or 4 hours every day, then she reads the entire book in 6 days. Okay. How many hours in all were required by her to read the book? Now what we do is we will change this section into. Actually, this is mixed fraction and we have to change it in improper fraction. So, Lipika takes every day. Lipika takes one whole 3 by 4 equals to 4 by 4 plus 3 is 4 plus 3 upon 4 this is 7 upon 4 half per day. For reading, for six times of the time will be taken by her. Okay, so what is that? This is our, listen, actually 7 upon 4 hours per day. Devika takes 1 whole 3 by 4 means 7 upon 4 hours per day for living. Okay, then in 6 days how many hours Lipka has taken equals to 6 is multiplied with 6 is this 6 is multiplied with 7 upon 4. Okay, 7 upon 4. 2 to the 4, 2 3 the 6. Okay, 3 7 is 21 upon 2 means this 21 should be divided by 2. Okay, then what will get it? 10 to the 20, then 1. 10 whole 1 upon 2. 10 whole 1 upon 2. 10 whole 1 upon 2. The simplest form
the simplest form, the simplest form of the number, the simplest form of the number, form of the number obtained in A, obtained the simplest form of the number, the simplest form of the number obtained in A is, okay. Now part B, question number 8, part B, sub part first is, provide the number in the box, provide the number in the box, provide the number in the box, number in the box, provide the number in the box, this one, such that, this one, such that, 3 by 5 divided in this box equals to 24 minus 25, 3 by 5 divided in this box equals to 24 minus 25, okay. Second one is the same as the subpart of A. The simplest form of the number obtained, the simplest form, the simplest form of the number, the simplest form of the number obtained in, obtained in this is. Provide the number in the box. Okay, so that 2 by 3 multiplied. Actually, we have to find out from which number. Why which number 2 by 3 is multiplied so that. Why which number 2 by 3 is multiplied so that. Why which number 2 by 3 is multiplied so that we get 10 and 30. Here we are seeing 2. We will divide our 10 by 2. Then 2 5s are 10. Hence, here we get a 5. Okay, I am taking another bracket so that it will be easy. 2 5 are 10, here 2 10 are 30. Okay, so our numerator should be 5 and numerator should be 10. 2 5 are 10 and 2 10 are 30. Okay, and the simplest form of 5 upon 10. Simplest form of 5 upon 10 is what? 5 and 5, 5 is that 1 upon 2. Okay, in is 1 upon 2. This is our answer. Next one is what? Our next one is our part B, which is provide the number in the box A such that 3 by 5 multiplied to the box equals to 24 upon 75. Then what we will do is 3, we will divide 24 by 3. 8 3 is 24. Here we will get a 8. 8 3 is 24. Now what we will do is we will divide our 75 by 5, 5 is 5 and 5 5 is 25. So this is our 75 divided by our 5, this is 15. Okay, our answer is 8 upon 15. Now here in this box we are getting 8 upon 15 and the simplest form is also 8 upon 15. Okay, now what we will do is we will go for exercise number next, which is exercise number 2.4. Exercise number 2.4 and question number first is what? It will be the exercise is fully exercise number 2.4 and the question number first is find what we have to find actually. The first part is 12 by 12 3 upon 4. The second part is what? Second part is 14 divided by 5 upon 6. Okay, third part is 8 divided by 7 upon 3.
Actually, I have already discussed with you that the exercise is fully based on the basic calculation.
Okay. So we will do the basic calculation. What we will go for is 4. Actually, this up to the time when for this division sign will be there, then we can't divide this number or we can't solve this question. Okay, so we have to convert this division sign into a multiplication sign. So 12 and multiplied with this fraction will be reciprocal. Okay, so 3 by 4 will change into 4 upon 3. Now what we get is 3, 4, 12, 4, 4, 16, the answer. 3, 4, 12, and 4, 4, 16 is our answer. Now this is 14 multiplied with this is 6 upon 5. Now what we do is we will just multiply. 14, 6, 6, 4, 24, and after the 6, 4, 24, and after that 6, 1, 24, 4, 2, carry. 6, 1, 6, 6, and 2 is 8. 55 upon 84 upon 5. We will divide our 84 by 5. Then 5, 1, 5, this is 3, this is 34. 5, 6, 30, this is 4. Now this is equals to 6, 5, 16 whole 4 upon 5 is our answer. Okay, if answer is different in the book, then it can also be written as when we divide our 4 by our 5, then 5 is 40, then this is 0.8, so it will be 16.8. Okay, now in our next part, what we will do is 8 and multiply by 3 upon 7. Okay, 8, 3 are 24 upon 7. Now we will divide our 24 by 7, what we will do is 7, 3 are 21, this is 3. Okay, so what we get is 3 whole 3 upon 7. 3 whole 3 upon 7 is our answer. Now our next one is 4 multiplied with 3 by 8. 4 minus 4, 4 is 8. 3 by 3 upon 2. It will be solved as okay, 2 minus 2, this is 1. This is 1 whole 1 upon 2. This is 1 whole 1 upon 2. Now in our next part, which is number 6, what we have to do is 3 and this fraction should be converted into a improper fraction. 3 to the 6, 6 plus 1 is 7, 3. So this is 3 and this division sign is converted into multiplication 3 upon 7. Now 3 is a 9 upon 7. We will divide our 9 by our 7. So what we get is 7 is 7, this is 2. Now this is what? 1 whole 2 upon 7 is our answer. 1 whole 2 upon 7 is our answer. Okay? So,
what we will go for is our number 6.
The 6th part is what we have to learn this. And after that, we will take our part 6, which is question number 2nd is find the reciprocal of each of the following. Find the reciprocal of Find the residual of each of the following fractions. Classify the reciprocals as a fraction. Classify the reciprocals. Classify the reciprocals as proper fractions. As proper fractions. Improper fractions and whole numbers. Proper fractions, improper fractions and whole numbers. Improper fractions. Find the reciprocal areas of following fractions. Classify the reciprocals as proper fraction, improper fraction, or whole numbers. Actually, this fraction originally was a proper fraction, but now this is an improper fraction because numerator is greater than denominator. So this is a improper fraction. Improper fraction. Improper fraction. Okay. Now. We will just reciprocal. We have reciprocal of this fraction which is 8 upon 5. Originally it was a proper fraction, but now our numerator is greater than our denominator, hence this is our improper fraction. Improper fraction. Okay, now this is 9.7. We will take reciprocal which is 7.9. Now what we will do is here I am seeing. Numerator is less than our denominator. This is proper fraction. Hence, this is proper fraction. Okay, now we will take the reciprocal of 6 upon 5, which is 5 upon 6. Hence, here our numerator is less than our denominator, so our this fraction is a proper, is again a proper fraction. Okay, in our next part, what we will do is
we have to look.
This is 12.7. Now the reciprocal is 7.7. Here our numerator is less than our denominator. Hence, this fraction is a proper fraction. Hence, our this fraction is a proper fraction. Now we go for 1/8. We will take reciprocal, which is 8/1. Now this is a clearly a number. And this is whole number. This is what? This is whole number. Okay.
Our seventh one is 1 upon 7.
Our seventh one is what? 1 upon 11. We will take reciprocal to 11 upon 1. Because to 11. Now this is a whole number. This is again a whole number. This is again our whole number.
Okay, so here we have solved our two questions
or of exercise number 2.4 and actually this is not video 2. This was video 2 of our exercise number 2.3. But then we have started our exercise number 2.4. Then this was just the first video of 2.4. Okay.
fraction which are real reciprocal is improper fraction, proper fraction or a whole number. Or a whole number, okay? So, in our first part, what we have to do is, our question was 3.7 reciprocal was just opposite means 7.3. And here we are seeing our numerator is greater than our denominator. Hence, this is our improper fraction. Okay, in our part second, we are given 5.8. So, we are given, what we are given is 5.8. After that, we are given 8.5. So, this is our improper fraction. After that, in our third part, we are given what 9.7 reciprocal is 7.9. Hence, this is our proper fraction. Number next is 6.5 reciprocal is 5.6. So, this is again our proper fraction. And all the parts are done in the same fashion or in the same way. Okay, so study properly and just revise them properly. Make a note of this one and after that, neat and clean your notebook. Okay, stay home, stay safe. Goodbye. Thank you.